concert which honors our seniors that was pomp and circumstance by the famous composer Elgar. I'd like to continue our program with our featured senior soloist, a name that none of us are unfamiliar with. This young man has accomplished more in the last 4 years musically in many different levels than perhaps any student that I've ever known. He's participated in the Cleveland Youth Wind Symphony, solo playing the Haydn Trumpet Concerto, has held the principal seat in the Cleveland Youth Orchestra, Cleveland Music School Settlement Jazz Orchestra, and the achievements go on and on. It's with a great deal of pleasure that we welcome Lyle Silman performing in Napoli.
Thank you.
Thank you.
point, I'd like to introduce the next conductor, who's going to be Dr. Beethoven's Ode to Joy. This is Molly Miller. She's our new associate conductor this year. She's a first-year teacher, a 1991 graduate of Euclid High School, and a 1997 graduate of Cleveland State University, where she was a music education major with a concentration in flute performance. And I just want to thank her for the wonderful job that she's been doing so far this year with the kids. She prepared the ensembles along with Mr. Sarich for solo and ensemble contests, and it's just been a tremendous help to the music department and especially to the woodwind section. So really want to thank her and wish her luck on her conducting debut here at Euclid High School.
Thank you. five score years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadows we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation. This momentous decree came as a great beacon light of hope to millions of Negro slaves who had been seared in the flames of withering injustice. It came as a joyous daybreak to end the long night of their captivity.
When the architects of our republic wrote the magnificent words of the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence, they were signing a promissory note to which every American would fall heir. This note was the promise that all men, yes, black men and white men, were created equal and would be guaranteed the inalienable rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
But there is something that I must say to those who stand on the warm thresholds which leads into the palace of justice. In the process of gaining our rightful place, we must not be guilty of the wrongful deeds. Let us not seek to satisfy our thirst for freedom by drinking from the cup of bitterness and hatred. We must forever conduct our struggle on the high plane of dignity and discipline. We must not allow our creative protests to degenerate into the physical violence. Again and again, we must rise to the majestic heights of meeting physical force with soul force. The militancy in the Negro community must not lead us to distrust all white people. We may, many of our white brothers, as evidenced by their presence here today, have come to realize that their dignity is tied with our dignity. And they have come to realize in their freedom is bound to ours that we walk alone. And as we walk together, we will pledge that we will stay together. We cannot turn back.
I am not unmindful that some of you have come here today out of great trials and tribulations. Some of you have come fresh from narrow jails. Some of you have come from areas where your quest for freedom has left you battered by police brutality and staggered by the winds of persecution. You have been the veterans of creative suffering. Continue to work in the faith that unearned suffering is redemptive. Go back to the slums and ghettos of our cities with the hope that somehow the situation can and will be changed. We cannot wallow in the valley of despair.
I say to you today, my friends, even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day the nation will rise up and live the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in the nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I have a dream today.
right in and give them a final thanks for their year and their contributions to our program. Our associate principal, Mr. Justin Antonini, for coming to our concert this evening. And we'd like all of you to join in clapping as we play the traditional ending of our season, conducted by our band president, John Philip Sousa, Stars and Stripes Forever.